morning, everybody. I am Dr. Mohit Bhandari. I am a minimal access, bariatric and a metabolic surgeon and the director of this institute. This particular institute is known as LASER, Laparoscopy Academy of Surgical Education and Research. It is basically a skill center which is attached to our medical college, Sri Aurobindo Medical College and Postgraduate Institute. When I went for my training to Strasbourg for minimal access surgery, I felt that there is a long gap which exists in our country between the number of people who want to, number of surgeons who want to pursue laparoscopic surgery and the training institutes. We need to develop a lot of training models, need to develop surgeons who can use these training models to decrease their learning curve. Because ultimately, if they are not decreasing their learning curve, it will take a long time for them to come into the mainstream. To take a surgeon into the mainstream, it is important that the surgeon develops his own training model, try and practice over the training model and decrease his learning curve, enhance his skill. To enhance this skill, we have developed this beautiful animal OT. It's a modular animal OT, one of its kind. The facilities which we have procured at this particular place are one of the best in the world. It is of international standards. I'll take you to one of the stations of this particular animal OT. This animal OT is a 10-station animal OT, and it's made up of a material which is fabricated by steel and epoxy coated, just like it is present in a normal human OT. If I take you towards the station of this particular animal OT, then we will find that here we are using pig as the training model. And to use pig as a training model, we are permitted by the CPSCA and the Ministry of Environment. But we need to comply to a lot of regulations. We have to treat animals in a very humane manner. They are for our experimental purposes, but we have to give them care more than we have to give to a human patient. So just to justify to what I am saying, If we go to one particular station of our animal OT, you can see that this is a OT table, and it's a remote operated OT table where through this remote you can change the different positions of the OT table. You can give a Treadlenburg, a reverse Treadlenburg, and different right up, left up, different sort of positions. This particular equipment is an animal ventilator. It's a special animal ventilator which has been designed. When we intubate the white pig, we keep this pig on this particular ventilator, and it's basically a workstation. So anesthetist is very comfortable, the wet anesthetist is very comfortable. This is basically a Mindray MEC-1200 wet monitor specifically designed for the animals and specifically white pigs, which has the arterial pressure probe, which has a venous pressure probe, a central venous line probe, a BP probe, which is one of its kind. And it's a very special kind of a monitor which helps to take care of the animal during the surgery. If we go to this particular station, which is our endovision system, I have always said that for any surgery, whether it's open or laparoscopic, the vision is the most important constituent of that particular surgery. If the vision is good, if you are able to see what you are doing, you will be doing it perfectly well. So this is this particular station. Here we have developed, we have procured all 3-chip cameras, and people do not even have 3-chip cameras during their practice, but for the learners here, we have got all 3-chip cameras, which are all by Karl Storz, and we have got a xenon light source. We have got a bipolar and a monopolar vessel sealer developed by the Veli Lab, and there is an insufflator. So this whole assembly, including the monitor, the 3-chip camera, the xenon light source, and the generator, that is the monopolar and a bipolar vessel sealer and the cautery system, it helps to do all the laparoscopic surgeries which are possible. We have separate instruments which contains our ports and hand instruments for every individual station. And if you find the whole lab, which we have built up, is a modular lab. This is just like any other modular OT. And if I could take you here in this particular lab, we see that the lab is a pendant based lab. And in this particular lab, we have got all the lines, like the oxygen lines, the nitrous, the carbon dioxide, the medicated air, the central suction and central evacuation system. So actually, a single unit at our lab, it's just like any OT, which is there for the human OT. And here we intubate the white pigs and we conduct a lot of courses. We have done our contract with the Karl Storz, which is supporting us for the endovision and laparoscopy, Olympus, which is supporting us for the gastroendoscopy and the bronchoscopy. And we have developed pig as our training model. We do courses for general surgery, like we do a lap colorectal course, a intensive laparoscopy course, a endo hernia course, NOTES course, we do a single axis course, and these are some of the courses which are dedicated to a particular subject. Like when we do a lap colorectal course in a general surgery, we do not talk about hernia. When we just talk about the colorectal, and the pig is the training model, and we do all the surgeries on the pig and train people how to have an approach on the pig. On a live pig, they do the surgery and they get a lot of confidence. Suppose we are undergoing an endo hernia course. That course will not speak about colorectal or intensive laparoscopy. That will be totally dedicated to hernia and procedures of all kind of hernia procedures. We train them to perform it on a live pig. For gynecology, we have got intensive lab gynecology course, lab suturing course, single axis gynec course, endometriosis course. Similarly, for orthopedics, we have got a total hip and a total knee replacement course. This is probably the only center in the country which has got the largest collection of the cadavers. We do not give formalin to our cadavers, but we store them in the refrigerator at minus 19 degrees Celsius, and the cadaver is as fresh it bleeds. So for orthopedics, we conduct the TKR and THR course, the arthroscopy course for shoulder and knee, and as well as wrist arthroscopy course. For neurosurgery, we conduct the base of the skull surgery course, and it is the one of the center where the base of the skull surgery course is conducted for both neurosurgeons and for the ENT surgeons. For the gastroenterology, we have developed a course where we use the pig model for the upper GI endoscopy. As all of you know that the colon of the pig is very spiral, so we have explant models for lower GI colonoscopy. We use the pig model for the ERCP training of the surgeons and the gastroenterologist. We use the pig model for endoscopic ultrasound training of the endoscopist. These are the course we conduct in gastroenterology. Well, talking about thorax, we conduct the course, a VATS course and a bronchoscopy course for thoracoscopists and the interventionists who are involved in the field of thoracoscopy. So these are some of the examples of our courses. Our only vision is to enhance competence. We believe that if the postgraduates who are coming to this particular institute get the exposure of just such training model, their learning curve is going to be reduced, and once they move out into the market, they will be professionally much more competent as compared to the other postgraduate institute. This is not only our vision, but it is our dream. Friends, now I'm going to take you live into a course which we did, and as you know that we do a lot of courses in a year. We do 15 to 20 international level courses in a year. I'll take you to one of the course known as the OSSICON 2011, where there was a dedicated whole day session of live animal OT, and bariatric surgeons or the budding bariatric surgeons or wannabe bariatric surgeons throughout the country and outside the country came and they did. Let's see what feel they have about the lab, about the setup laser, and what the faculty feel about the setup laser. Let's go to that place.
Welcome to Laparoscopy Academy of Surgical Education and Research Laser at Sri Aurobindo Institute of Medical Sciences, Indore. Right now, OSSICON 2011 is being held here, and delegates from various parts of the world are here to perform bariatric surgery on live animal and fresh cadaver models. So let's go to the animal OT or wet lab of laser, meet the delegates and share their experiences about how does it feel being at laser. Thank you. So I have with me Dr. Luc Lemmens from Belgium. Namaste sir. How are you doing?
Very good, thank you.
And first of all, welcome to India, welcome to Indore and welcome to laser. How do you find this place?
Very nice. It's brand new. I saw it on the internet. It looks well. It's really perfect.
I'm sure you have been to such places earlier before.
Yeah, we've seen that. We have that in Belgium. We have some in Europe, of course. But it's perfect. It's the same as we have in Europe. Very nice.
So before you came to India, before you came to laser, you must have seen these things on internet, and your picture on the internet and the actual picture differs.
Looks okay. I expected it because I've seen it on the internet. It's just perfect. It's nice working place.
And
the meaning is that it can stay like this for forever, just as training for students.
Yeah,
for trainees.
Indeed.
Yes. So it's very expensive. I was told that big labs are very expensive. It's the same over here. It's less expensive in Europe or in Belgium. When we organize during conference pig labs, the cell is really, really expensive because the price per pig is expensive because they're prepared for that. But the same over here, or is it less expensive? Do you have any idea?
Thank you. Okay, so I have with me Dr. Juan from Taiwan, and I would like to greet you in Indian style. Namaste.
Hi.
How are you doing?
Yeah.
And welcome to India. Welcome to Indore and welcome to Laser.
Yeah.
How do you find this place?
In fact, this time I was invited by the faculty of this meeting, and I have been to India for 3 times. It's a very nice country, and I think that it's very friendly people and to talk. So I think the priority surgery and medical surgery is gaining the more and more importance in the country. So for the Asian priority surgeons, we would like to help in this area. Yeah, so I think when I got invited for this meeting, I'm really happy to come here to see the equipment. In my country and in my hospital, we also have the same facility of minimally invasive training centers. So it's almost the same. There's 10 tables and all the same equipment. So I think we can provide good training for the people. It has been very good, you know, the top equipment, top technology. So right now it is can proceed for 20 years more. I think for this equipment to train the new surgeons. But maybe 20 years later we can go to another new robotic training system, maybe.
Your word, one word about this place. Please.
Okay,
please. Just one word about this place.
Excellent works.
That's all. Thank you very much, and it was a great pleasure to meet you. I hope you enjoy India.
Okay. Thank you so much.
Have a good day. I have with me Dr. Sameer Badami from Pune. How are you doing, sir?
Very well, very well.
And he is here as a participant for OxyCon 2011. So how does it feel being at Laser?
Very good. It's a very wonderful experience. I'm very happy.
You'll be busy with staplers and everything.
Yes, stapler is not a wonder surgery. It really helps. I think my confidence is very sky high. I'm feeling much better.
So is this the first time you're attending such a course?
No, I have attended such courses before. Twice in fact, two such courses. This is the best time.
And for sure. Your views about the whole setup at Laser
is very good. It's very good. The equipment, the camera. We definitely do better with the staplers, but other things are wonderful.
Here at OxyCon 2011, sir, how does it feel being here at Laser?
Wonderful. Mohit is an excellent host. All of you guys are keeping us very, very happy. And looking at this animal lab, it's I can't even imagine that India has one. Such a big one there.
Tough question. One word for Laser.
Extraordinary.